Hello and welcome to the Digital Arts Department at Ori Georgetown Technical College. Let's explore all this program has to offer. I'm delighted to welcome you today. I'm Professor Belzotti. If you would like more information about the program or to register for classes, please don't hesitate to reach out to myself, Professor Moroz, or Professor Timmons. Our curriculum is 5 semesters long. Here's an at-a-glance list of the classes you'll need to obtain this degree. I know this list may seem long and might not resonate with you, so I've compiled a list of projects to better illustrate what this looks like. So we're going to explore each one of the semesters individually. You can find out this information more on the website if you'd like to refer back to it again. All students in the program will acquire a solid education in design theory and art history. During the first year, students will focus on basic design skills, creative software, and digital photography. In the second year, they'll learn more advanced skills in advertising design, production, multimedia techniques, including web and video. Adobe software training is really important to us here since it's the industry standard and the leader in creative software. So you're going to learn all of those programs. You're going to learn anything from Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, Adobe XD, Adobe Premiere Pro, After Effects, Audition, and Fresco. Let's look at some examples work so that we can go through the process. In your first semester of the fall, you're going to start with Design 1, Computer Graphics 1, and Photography. All of these classes work together to help give you the foundation of what you need to know in order to start your career in digital arts. So you can see the example on the upper left, the shape and line poster. This is an exercise where we have you pick an element or principle and you further illustrate what that element or principle is, and you create a poster representing that element or principle. And then below it, you're going to see a business card. We have you do a logo and a business card also in Design 1. And then we work on making mock-ups to make it look like it's actually been printed so that you can use these in your portfolio going forward. And it's a nice way to display your artwork. Then in Computer Graphics, you'll see the middle poster that was created in Photoshop. That's an exercise called Sound as Image, where you get to pick your favorite song and then illustrate that in Photoshop with images, learning how to mask and use the tools available in Photoshop. And in photography, you're going to study 6 different genres of photography. You're going to learn how to practice getting the right exposure for the right technique, using your camera, and finding out what all of the parameters mean. In these two examples, you see the sports shoot and a portrait shoot or night shoot. Those are some of the students' favorite to explore, but you'll be able to hone in on that part of the creative aspect in capturing images. As we continue in your first year, the second semester, spring courses, you're going to have Typography, Computer Graphics 2, and Graphic Reproduction 1. In Graphic Reproduction 1, you're going to work on some great projects that actually put work into actuality. So what I mean by that, you get to build a calendar and not only just design it, but you get to print it and actually bind it together, along with learning all the techniques that goes into not just creating, but how to actually produce a piece. Then Computer Graphics 2 is a continuation of what you had in the fall with Computer Graphics 1. You'll see that example up in the upper left of the NASA Space Shuttle program. One of the exercises is to create a poster from a historical event or a tribute to something and create a poster that's visually interesting and pleasing on the eyes. So in this case, you can really see how this student took what they've learned from that semester and put it all into this poster. You can see the advancement in not only the creativeness of it, but in the execution. So honing in on those computer graphic skills is really going to help advance your career. Then in Typography, you're going to work on learning more about how type speaks and has meaning, and then you're going to put that into several posters. I have 2 examples here of typographers and how they put them into a poster. In your third semester, which is during the summer, you're going to be focusing on 2 things. The first is ARV 227, which is web design. You're going to be learning web banners, email blasts, social graphics, websites, and you're going to be able to build your own app using Adobe XD. Here are some examples that you can see from last year's class and with the banners. And then I've included an example app, an example website, so you can explore that as well. You simply just take a picture of this with your, or shoot a picture of this with your phone, and it'll take you to a website that is working and links actually move or navigate in through their site or app. During the summer, you also take an internship, and this is a requirement for all digital arts students, but you get to use all the skills that you've learned so far and put them into practice in a real-world experience. The internship usually lasts from the middle of May until the beginning of August. You need to have about 15 hours a week for a total of 150 hours for this internship requirement. Things that you can be creating are social posts, logos, flyers, invitations, posters, and web graphics. In your fourth semester in the fall, you'll be taking Advertising Design 1 and Graphic Reproduction 2. And then these two courses, you're really going to put into play some creative campaigns and ideas. So I've got a couple examples here, but I've got a few more details to them in the next few slides. In Advertising Design 1, the students are given two random letters. And from those random letters, they have to create a whole product. So they have to come up with what it's going to be. They have to come up with the logo and then make a campaign and even a product, a display, a packaging of that item. So this right here in this example, the student was given an E and a J. And from that, she created Easy Juice. She not only did this campaign and she wrote it as well as executed all the creative. She dreamed up the packaging for it and got to really make this look like a real world thing. So you get some practice at dreaming up something from concept and then all the way through creation until you actually produce it. Here's another example where the student was given a G and an S and she came up with Green Sage Tea Company. And this is her campaign. And this student was given a K and a C, and this is how he dreamed up his Kickin' Chicken ads. This student took not just the visuals, but also the interpretation of color theory and used the color theory in his execution of this ad campaign, really drawing you in with the copy, which was written by him, and the artwork. In the fifth and final semester, everything you've been working on all comes together. In your capstone class, you and a few classmates are grouped together to form your own advertising agency, in which you'll create a brand for one of our culinary students' restaurants ideas. Everything you have learned is used in this project, and then at the end of the semester, you will pitch your idea to a panel of judges. See the image on your left of your screen to see what that looks like. In Advertising Design 2, you'll prepare all of your work that you've done over the last five semesters and display your work in our annual showcase held in April, in which over 200 people attend. And last but not least, you'll take a Multimedia Techniques and Special Topics class where you will learn Premiere Pro, After Effects, Adobe Audition, Fresco, and many more creative techniques to help you be better creative. Right here on the right is an example of an animation created in After Effects. To help further illustrate some of the video work that we do, I wanted to give you a couple of examples. In this example, students were asked to create a day in the life of something. Could be anything they wanted. Some ideas that were created were a day in the life of their pets, their eyeglasses, and their electronics. But here's an example of a student who created a day in the life of a business owner. In the last video project, we create a tourism commercial for Visit Myrtle Beach. You're provided a library of videos from the Myrtle Beach Area Chamber of Commerce. You sketch out a storyboard, create a script, and then take it into Premiere and put it all together. Here's an example of one of those commercials.
60 miles of white sand and warm sun. There is so much to do and so much to see. All in a place where you can be yourself and have fun together too. Only at the beach. Myrtle Beach. It's no wonder that this is the ideal family vacation destination. So come join us soon. We can't wait for you to visit, because this is where you belong.
As you've seen, this program may only be 2 years, but we pack a lot in, so you get a comprehensive view and training in digital arts and graphic design. Graduates of the digital arts program can possess many different types of jobs in advertising, public relations, graphic design, website design, photography, and video. For students wishing to continue their education, HGTC has developed transfer agreements with a number of four-year institutions, including CCU, Charleston Southern University, and Francis Marion University. We'd love to speak with you anytime, so please don't hesitate to reach out to Professor Moreau's or myself, Professor Belzotti. Thank you!